went from a storefront to a national and international organization, and that's amazing.
If a person like me have just came in to, you know, to ask for help, I don't think he can do it, he or she can do it without access. Because I know I couldn't have done it without access.
Without coming in here to Michigan Works, and especially access, and getting enrolled in school in a high demand curriculum or area of study that will lead to eventual employment, it was like a small miracle in my life.
I came for a regular checkup for mammogram. And they found out that I had cancer. They saved my life.
The mission of Access is really to provide human services in a humane fashion and to really empower people so that they can lead fulfilling lives and really become a part of the greater American society.
There are people to admire. Obviously, I'm proud of what they do, and obviously, I think that they've done a great job in terms of not just working for Arab Americans or Muslims, but serving everybody from every race and creed, color here in Michigan. And they are, as a matter of fact, a rather remarkable group because they're also being emulated in other parts of the country.
I had three children looking back at me. I'm telling them, you better get good grades and then have a high school diploma. Access made me do that. And me and my oldest son, we graduated the same year.
And I think it's the leadership of Access that really makes a major difference.
One of the things that impresses me the most about the Arab American National Museum is that they kind of serve two functions. One is clearly to preserve the culture and heritage of the Arab American culture, which is so important to this country. But the other is that they serve as a real support and basis for gathering and networking within the community itself.
The NAC affiliation is really, I look at it like a fraternity relationship in which we share experiences, we share resources between us and other organizations all over the United States.
I see NAC as an organization that becomes the one voice for the Arab American community. They are one of the only grassroots organizations right now that are actually on the ground serving the people and that understand the problems of the Arab American community.
One of my fantasies is to hear the word Arab Americans supporting programs like NPR, PBS, the Opera, or whatever other institution. And nobody has ever done that except Access. And Access has created CAP, which is the Center for Arab American Philanthropy, to provide an avenue for Arab Americans to give to our community. It's a way of harnessing the collective energy of the Arab American community to shape the future.
I want to give back to them for everything they gave to me as I grew up there my whole life with Access. And my mom also, she went to school there, and every, you know, it's like, it's in the family, it's in the blood.